How's it going, everybody? I got a burp.
Go ahead, bro.
Nope. It's passing.
Hell yeah.
We're good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was one of those silent burps that you let out on the side.
Yeah, I'll let it out later.
Episode 33.
We're back.
We're back. We never left.
We've actually just been here. But here's
the
thing. We didn't finish episode 32, and then immediately Diego was like, all right, episode 33, and we started.
Let's go.
We've been here all week.
We've been in Diego's house. We haven't recorded anything all week,
no,
but we've just been here.
But we've been in Diego's house.
And say, all right.
All right, cool.
Back to the thing.
Next episode, baby.
Next episode, baby. All right. We can update me, bro.
We can update you.
Yeah.
We were just talking about this before. I don't know what has happened this week other than the Golden Globes. The Golden Globes were last night. Actually,
they were last night, right?
Here's the thing. I'm trying to think of like whenever this is going to come out. I think this is going to come out like next week.
Yeah, probably, I think.
So for everybody listening, the Golden Globes were last week.
Last week.
But for us, it was last night.
Exactly. For us, it was literally last night.
And it was like the first time I think I'd ever like watch the Golden Globes all the way through. Because we've talked about award shows before.
Yeah.
And I really only ever watch... The only award show I'll typically watch all the way through is the Tonys and the Oscars.
Dude, I watched I think I said it, but I watched the Grammys all the way through.
That's tough. I can't...
That was the worst. Like, it was like more than three-fourths country. And
yeah.
I was like, y'all have a separate music award show.
Y'all have y'all definitely have the country music awards.
Yeah, I was like... Jesus. And like that's when I figured out like all these new people that I have never heard of. Like the sad part is that they're all these new artists and they were all winning awards and I was like, who are they?
Yeah.
I was like, I didn't know who Casey Musgraves was.
I still don't know who Casey Musgraves is, and I listen to country music.
And then I was like, yeah, and then then she won like four and I was like, what?
It's what?
It's like, damn.
I still don't know who that woman is.
But hey man, numbers don't lie, so
yeah.
Obviously, for whatever reason, whatever.
I think I've tried to watch. I tried to watch the Grammys. When was it? It was when Damn had just come out.
So Kendrick Lamar. So 2017.
Because did
no,
he host? Did he host or did he just perform?
Kendrick. No, he performed, and then he won rap album.
Did Damn win?
Yeah, he won.
Okay, good.
He performed. No, I know what you're talking about. I know the performance. Cause
when
Dave
Chappelle came on.
Yeah, and then there's like a bunch of people locked up in jail and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it was like, whoa, like really moving. I remember that.
I remember I watched that, and then I think I watched a little bit more, and I was like, okay, this is boring.
That was a while ago, though.
Yeah, I think that was the last time
I
watched the Grammys.
Oh, yeah, it was
the
worst 3.5 hours of my life.
Yeah.
Like, we watched it as friends. We were expecting like at least, I think we wanted Astroworld to win because it just had
was
such
that the
a
same
great
year?
No, I was
oh,
talking about
when
this.
You watched.
Yeah. And we were like, oh, it's been such a great year. He wrote it out. If it doesn't win, Mac Miller will probably win. And then that's when Cardi B won. And it was like,
oh,
we watched four hours of like this
for Cardi B just to win.
For Cardi B, isn't it crazy that Kendrick Lamar on camera has said, yeah, the first time I was tossed, there was three other people in the room. Like
so confidently.
Like,
you know what?
That's such go ahead.
That's the confidence of somebody who wrote Damn.
Yeah.
And literally also curated the Black Panther album.
Dude, that's always in hip hop music though. Like,
yeah,
busting down a bitch with my brothers. It's like, why is that a thing?
Why is that a thing?
Yeah, like that's not.
I don't think I would even feel weird with like with a brother being in the same
house. Be like, damn, let me quiet down.
Be like, hey yo bro, go run some errands real quick.
Yeah, can you leave real quick?
Can
yeah
leave
no
real
but
quick?
No, he's just, they were in the room as I was getting tossed.
Tossed,
dude, what the heck,
as Kendrick was getting tossed. Imagine tossing Kendrick Lamar's salad.
I don't want to
Comes to the brain. I got a headache.
All right, edit it out in post.
Edit it out.
Perfect. So I was thinking the other day, because I was eating an apple,
mm-hmm,
and I was like...
Were you keeping the doctor away?
Yeah, literally. I was like, this apple has so much, like, meat to it. Like, an apple has so much, like...
I get what you're saying.
Yeah, like, I was eating that apple for a while, right? I thought about it. I was like, damn, like, the most obnoxious thing is, like, you could do is, like, eat an apple, though. Because it's just, like...
It is. Dude, here's the thing about an apple.
Yeah.
An apple is such a commitment. Don't you dare. You...
No, keep going, will you?
Homeboy really brought an apple out. Say what you want about Juan, but he really has an apple now. But
yeah,
an apple is like a whole apple is such a commitment. Cause I'm a slice boy. I'll cut it into slices.
No, yeah, I like, now I'm just going to eat this apple.
Yeah.
but
and enjoy it. It looks like a good apple. Oh,
but
that's a good bite you took too.
It's a Honeycrisp. That's the best kind
of apple. The best kind of apple, yeah. But your hands are sticky afterwards.
A little bit.
You got a sticky hand after.
But yeah, no. Apples are a commitment.
Yeah. I don't know why a whole apple feels more like a commitment. It feels more of a commitment than eating apple slices. I don't know why.
It is. Because an apple slice, you can be like, I'll have one. And it's like a definite.
And you can leave it.
Yeah.
Yeah. With an apple, you're like, it's like a time bomb. You're like, oh, if I got to eat this apple now. I eat this whole apple. Do you?
Sorry.
I
was. I had to think about how I was eating the apple.
Yeah, but.
Oh wow, that apple just
took me out.
Slices, great.
I would rather eat slices.
Isn't it weird that food tastes different when you slice it?
What?
Or feels different?
It does feel different.
Banana slices than just palming a banana and eating it?
I'm gonna keep it a buck with you, Chief. I'm gonna be 100 with you. I'm not a banana boy.
That's okay. Well, apple. Like, just put in perspective with the apple.
Oh, no. Apple slices definitely taste different.
Yeah, right. Not even just taste different, but it's just more fun.
I think the last time I had a banana was whenever you and I ate the Dole Dippers.
Oh,
when
yeah.
When we went to 3 HEBs.
So, it was the bananas covered in chocolate.
Yeah.
Wasn't it ended up being in the one closest to us?
Yeah.
That's good.
We went
to
Waco. We were in Waco. For some reason, we were in Waco.
I know the reason. But we wanted we wanted to try the strawberry ones, I remember, because those one look substantially better than
those one look so good. And there were peach ones too that we wanted.
That's the same night I watched all of the boys.
You did watch all of the boys.
I and I just had a plate of Dole Dippers in front of me.
I remember,
here, let me set the scene. It was like 4 a.m. I was on the like 6th or 7th episode of the boys, and I said, damn, I'm kind of already here. I don't want to save one or two for tomorrow. Plate of Dole Dippers in hand.
Dole Dippers in hand. One hand on my thigh.
Yeah, and oh my God. Ah, you know, this is what we were... Okay. Just
Do you want to put a pin in the boys?
No, okay, and then there's Dole Dippers in front of me. But like, that's it. That's the scene. And then I watched it until 5. Dude, that feeling you get when...
Oh my God.
You finally... Oh my gosh.
Dude,
realize what I had something to talk about, because me and Diego were talking before you got here.
Goodness.
And oh my gosh. Wow. That felt so good. I don't know how Diego remembered.
That was such a release that I'd watched you go through.
Yeah, dude, I gotta
take a bite of your apple.
That. Like, damn.
That was so visceral.
Anyways. Okay, keep going with what you're talking about.
Well, you wanna save this? Okay. Well, what I was talking about the Golden Globes.
Oh yeah, yeah. Man, Ricky Gervais really gave it to everybody.
Ricky Gervais really let everybody know.
That Brit.
That filthy Brit.
It's weird because everybody was like, I heard that afterwards. Like,
everybody was like,
oh yeah, like he really like. I know the press beforehand was that basically like, he's gonna be outlandish, and then he was outlandish. And then apparently he did it well. I don't know.
He did it well.
Yeah, okay, because everybody really liked
it. The audience seemed to really be, like, enjoying it, because I think, like what I told y'all before, he was really kind of, like, holding a mirror up to him, and they were like, damn, that's true.
Yeah.
But for some reason, watching the Golden Globes, I realize that there are actors and actresses that I really just don't like as, like, people. Love his work. I'm not the biggest fan of Joaquin Phoenix as a person.
That's honestly fair, because when you told me what he did, I was like, dang. You could have written that beforehand.
He could have. And then who else? Oh, Saoirse Ronan.
The heck does she do?
She was in Lady Bird. She's one
whatever.
You know what? She's one of those, like, there's like 10 actors and actresses that are only in period piece movies.
Yeah.
Chalamet is one of them.
Yes. Do you think... Yeah, he was like a Night King Arthur or something.
Yeah.
Do you think the Golden Globes count? And I'm being honest. Because, like, whenever
I'd
hear people...
So.
You do?
I'd say the Golden Globes count.
The actor's choice, though, right? Like, who people think would win?
No,
and then Oscars is the Academy?
Oscars is the Academy. And the Academy is, like... It's, like, an amalgamation of, like, a bunch of people. So, it's, like, directors, cinematographers, screenwriters, actors, costumers, like... everything. I think the Golden Globes is like a committee of something else. I think it's the HFA, the HPFA or something.
I just always thought, I was like, damn, man. Like, every time I heard like a Golden Globe winner, I was like, okay.
It's like it's kind of like, it's the pregame for the Oscars. Like, it gives you an idea of who's going to win the Oscars.
I don't know if Joaquin can do the best actor, though, because I feel like the Oscars don't want that. Even though he, like, does, even if they deserve it, it's not a good look for a Joker to win. You know what I mean?
Well, whenever he won, I was kind of, like, left with, I was like, oh, well, I mean, that's good he won. But I was still kind of just like, I don't know if he was the best.
Who is he up against, though?
Let's see. He was up against, like, I think because you know how they split the best actor and actress into drama and then musical and comedy?
Oh, I didn't, but nice.
So, yeah, that's what they do, which is cool because it gives more people.
Yeah, because there's a lot of movies that come out.
Yeah. And so I think for him, it was Joaquin, Adam Driver.
For what? Oh, the one with Scarlett Johansson?
Yeah.
What movie is that?
Marriage Story, which didn't win as much as people thought it was.
No, I didn't know that was... What would it up? Is it literally just about a marriage?
It's just about a marriage, like, it's just about a divorce. That's it.
I just kept seeing that scene running around everywhere.
Where Adam Driver punches a wall and then he's like,
meh. Yeah, literally. Yeah, exactly. He does literally that.
But I'm trying to think of, I think, wasn't Anthony Hopkins. I don't remember. But I was watching it with Harley and we were both like, oh, yeah, I think it's going to be these two. And none of them were Joaquin Phoenix. But then when Joaquin won, we were like, okay. Like, okay. I'm happy for him.
Yeah. It's like, all right.
But, yeah, it was good. 1917 won a lot, and I did not expect it to win.
The hell is 1917?
1917 is the World War One movie coming out about the two. Shit. There's, like, it's about two soldiers having to get a message, like, across Europe. To this battalion who's like walking into a trap, and like if they don't make it in time,
they'll walk into the trap.
Yeah, like 17,000 people will die.
Well, damn, I want to watch that.
I want to watch it too. And apparently, it's edited to look like all one shot.
Oof.
Yeah.
Wow.
So you know I'm gonna be chubbing while watching that movie. But literally, that movie won Best Film for drama, and I think it won Best Director. And then Once Upon a Time in Hollywood won Best Film for Musical or Comedy.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
I guess it was a comedy, I guess.
Yeah. Also, Taron Egerton won for, what's his name?
Oh.
What's the movie that Rocket Man's about?
Elton John.
Elton John. He won for Rocket Man. He won for playing Elton John.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well, there's your 2020 Golden Globe wrap-up.
Yeah. Also, Renee Zellweger's speech was wacky as hell, and she also got played off like Joaquin Phoenix.
What did she talk about?
You couldn't even understand her because of how much plastic surgery is in her face.
Damn.
It was rough.
That's fucked up.
Yeah.
Speaking of plastic surgery, there's this thing. This is the thing that was reminded to me. I had read an article the other day about a really niche job, actually. This guy's job is... he investigates, his whole career, basically, not really a job at this point. It started with one and then he found more cases. So it turned into a career, but he, investigates doctors and nurses who, are accused of murdering their patients. And that's just, isn't it weird that that happens so much that,
yeah,
that is specific
that you need a...
Yeah.
You need somebody for it?
Yeah, exactly. And
what?
Yeah, so I want to talk about that because, like, it's just so, like, interesting.
So, yeah, so,
you
okay.
You know, like, there's a lot of angles you can take it from. Diego was bringing this up with me, but he said that sometimes it's for, like, even stardom. Not stardom in like, the sense you might be thinking, but, like, they want to be, like, a hero. So they're, uh-huh. like... Instead of doing something that would be really routine, you know, like whatever of insulin, whatever of morphine, whatever, they'll like do it manually and then they'll put either more or less depending on what effect. And then they'll come in and be like, I know what's wrong. And then they'll like fix it. And then they'll be, but in the process, a lot of times people die.
Oh.
And then it's just like, you know, so it's like they want to be like a hero. Like,
so then they, like,
problem,
stage it.
But it was, like, a problem that wasn't even supposed
Yo.
To be solved.
Yo!
Mm-hmm. It's crazy, yeah.
That's
and,
insane.
But yeah, no, they try to basically like induce a type of emergency. So when they do the insulin, when they do the potassium, when they do all that to induce whatever medical effect.
Oh my gosh.
It's like a, not like a thing where it's like they do it and then later throughout the day it'll be like, you know, oh, his potassium was high, let me lower that. It'll be like they want like a stage.
Like they want like they want,
yeah,
the theatrics.
They want to have to rush in and be like, ah, and then save and him because he's having cardiac arrest or whatever is going on.
Whoa.
And yeah, there's even a series called Nurses Who Kill that cover a lot of cases about that. So if y'all are interested in that type of thing, dude, on Netflix, Nurses Who Kill, all about that. And think about it. Think how hard it is to catch those people.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
You know, because it's just like, I was just doing my job and I did it wrong. Like, because
I don't think you can have cameras in hospital rooms.
I don't think so.
It works like a bathroom.
Yeah, it works like the doctor-patient confidentiality.
Yeah,
and all
I don't think you're allowed to have cameras in hospital rooms.
And even just that, but like,
which is kind of ridiculous when you think about it.
And like, even through, just think about it, like investigating, that just sounds difficult. Like, yeah, having to be like, no, you did that on purpose. Because it's like medicine is so up in the air anyway.
Yeah.
Not really.
Oddly enough, it is.
Right? Right? Because it's like
insane.
You learn so much when you become a doctor. You learn so much.
Yeah.
And it's just you're learning things to apply to scenarios. But that doesn't mean that's, you know, this symptom equals this, you know? It's just being a doctor is figuring out what's wrong and then treating it, you know?
Yeah.
So it's like there's just so much that is up in the air that it's just like, I feel like it'd be so difficult to prove, but.
Oh, yeah. Those are. Yeah. Yeah. That'd be ridiculous.
Yeah. A little interesting thing that I thought about the whole thing was that. Because you do kind of wonder, it's like, how did that become your thing?
Yeah.
But yeah, no. After the first case, everybody was like, hey.
Hey, bro. My doctor killed me.
Pretty sure this happened over here, too. Yeah. It's like.
That's insane.
Yeah. Pretty crazy. But that's the thing that I didn't remember. And
that's
like
a movie or a TV show.
Yeah. Hey.
I'd like to watch that.
Nurse. I don't remember what it was called already, but hey.
Something reminded me, just like one of like the username. This is completely off topic, but
yeah.
One of the usernames reminded me of this. So the other day I asked my friend Christian, who's like big K-pop boy. And I was just sitting there.
He's the
thinking,
one you went to Blackpink with, right?
Yeah, he was the one I went to Blackpink with. And I was just sitting there and I was thinking, I was thinking about how, like, when actors or actresses are just like big pop culture icons die, and how, like, for like maybe a week or two, there's like a mourning period over like social media and stuff. And so I asked him, I was like, dude, what if one of the BTS members died? Probably, I was like, probably one of the biggest music acts in the world
currently.
Like,
dude, that would be so crazy.
Well, yeah. And I was thinking, because I was like, because even though like neither of us are really like really care about it,
hey, speak for yourself, bro.
Bro, I'm actually in love with BTS. But exactly, it'd be like when John Lennon died or like when Elvis died.
Well,
I wasn't there,
so I don't know what you mean.
So but
it would be like a more than just the cultural impact. It would be like we lost somebody.
Yeah, like I was just
like a good human being. That,
like I wanted to know.
I don't know
what he think would happen. So I wanted to know from somebody who is like in the culture.
Yeah, because I feel like he's the one who could tell you.
Yeah, and so I asked him. I was like, what would happen if one of the BTS members died, like any of them? And he was like, I don't even want to think about that. Like he didn't even want to talk to me about
it's
it.
It's just Jonestown drinking the Kool-Aid. Yeah. All the BTS fans,
they're like, everybody, we gotta be with him. But yeah, he was like, I don't even want to think about that. And I was like, come on, dude. Like, what do you think would happen? And he'd be like, he's like, I think it'd be like, if any other, like, what happens when any other K-pop idol dies? Because apparently suicide rates amongst K-pop stars are pretty high.
Really?
They're really high.
I did not know that.
Yeah. Apparently.
And it's suicide, too.
Yeah. Apparently a good amount of them kill themselves. But
I mean, imagine being just idolized that much.
Yeah. Just being treated like a god.
I don't want to feel like a god.
All of the rules that they have. Insane.
Oh yeah. Like you can't be like a.
They can't. I'm sure they can't, like, be dating.
Yeah.
They can't. Most of them can't leave their building without like it's basically like the president almost.
Yeah, because they're just such a... That's the weird part, and I think that's why you get the really weird, crazy fans, is because they make them an enigma almost.
They make them untouchable.
Yeah, and it's like, they're pure, they don't have sex, they don't do any of this, they're just these... This is what they do.
They are gods.
Yeah, and it's just like... I can see why I would kill myself.
But that's just me.
I'm glad you didn't say anything when I said that.
Yo!
But that's just me.
It just let off. I was like, yeah, and I would kill myself. No, yeah.
Can we end it there?
I would,
like, even
myself.
If we're just 15 minutes in, just be like,
yeah,
I mean,
we're
20
minutes.
I would kill myself.
The lo-fi. I mean,
I would kill myself. But I told him, I was like, I don't think it would be the same as if anyone else killed themselves. Like, I was like, it'd definitely be different.
Yeah, it wouldn't. Especially BTS.
Yeah, especially BTS.
Behind the scenes.
Behind the scenes. Like, we would get no more behind the scenes special features.
Bring the sack.
Break the sack.
Stop, please.
All right. yeah. it would be detrimental to everybody.
Like, even though we don't care about like K-pop, we would still feel it.
We would still feel the repercussions.
Yeah. He was like, and he told me, he was like, there would be a deep mourn. And he even said, he was like, deep. I would be inconsolable. And I was like, damn.
When did he get into that?
He got into that maybe... I'd say I think he got into it like a senior year of high school, freshman year of college.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I'd say so. But yeah. No, like, the way... K-pop idols are like looked at is insane.
Yeah,
I couldn't imagine being looked at like that.
It's like the natives when they saw Spaniards on horses.
They're like, whoa!
It's the exact same thing, and you can't convince me otherwise.
Speaking of horses, I got asked this question yesterday, and I want to know your opinion.
Okay.
Would you rather fight the entire cast of Cats, or no? The entire cast of Cats, and they're as tall as this table.
So many ambiguities already.
Yeah.
So are they also cats?
They're the cats that they are in the movie.
Okay. Like, they're basically, if the movie things were real, they're fighting you?
Exactly.
Okay. And it's not like I'm fighting Idris and I'm... Like...
No, you're not fighting... You're fighting Idris Elba. You're fighting Cat Idris Elba.
Is the bull edited out?
No, Bulge is left swinging.
If you hear a voice in the background, that's just my subconscious.
Stop, please.
So, the cast of Cats, about as tall as this table. It's about, like, what would you say, 2 feet?
That's like... right below 3 feet.
Think about this. Rebel Wilson is involved in this.
I'm thinking.
So, the cast of Cats, about 2 feet tall, all of them.
Or, you know what this already reminds me of? Reminds me of that question where it's like, how many toddlers could you defeat before it's too many toddlers and you get, like, tuckered out?
I'm going to be honest. That's where I got that. That's where this question came from, because I started by asking that question.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, but okay.
So, the entire cast of Cats, 2 feet tall.
2.5 feet tall.
Or one horse-sized Judi Dench cat.
Diego, could you pull up Judi Dench so I can know what I'm dealing with?
Pull up
with?
Judi Dench as a cat.
Ludwig. So we get one horse. Okay, so
one horse-sized Judi Dench cat.
How many cats are there in the cast? If you can kind of ballpark it real quick.
I'd say there's about, like, that's Judi
Oh
Dench.
Oh my god. Oh my god, that's terrifying.
That jump scared him.
Jesus Christ. Isn't she the one who dies?
No, she's the one who chooses who dies.
Oh God!
Yeah, she's.
And
the
I
one
have
who,
to kill that.
And you have to kill old Deuteronomy.
I would be. Oh, she's Deuteronomy.
Yeah,
I thought Deuteronomy was a dude.
Typically, it is.
Come on.
But she came out and she was like, "My character's trans."
Did she really?
I think she did.
Oh my God! So I gotta fight a trans.
You have to, which is on you,
horse-sized...
which makes you transphobic.
Yeah, yeah. Because why did I even bring that up, right?
Exactly.
Why
did you have to bring that up?
I don't know what's wrong with me, honestly.
Yeah.
I'm just going to kill myself. That was crazy. Okay, so, dude, I can't take a horse-sized Judi Dench.
You
there's
don't think
so? Much, there's so much maneuvering, and, like, I have to think of, like, oh, my God, this is so gross.
Look at the cockroaches.
Is this a real scene in the movie?
This is an actual scene.
Tell the people what I'm seeing right now. What the hell?
It's the Rebel Wilson. It's Rebel Wilson's number. It's very early in the movie. Don't worry. So you get out of the way quick.
That's so mean to her.
It's Rebel Wilson's number. And it's just like, it has like tap dancing cockroaches, but it doesn't look like the CGI team like edited the cockroaches' faces. So it just looks like photoshopped faces on dancing cockroaches.
And then the cats are eating them.
The cats are eating them. You know what made me super uncomfortable watching the Cats movie?
For the second time?
Because unfortunately I saw it twice.
Mm-hmm.
There's like a point when Old Deuteronomy first shows up and they start dancing. Like they're all just like celebrating that she's there. And Jason Derulo comes in and he's like, "It's time to party, with your permission." And Judy Dench is like,
"Yes."
And then they all start dancing like crazy. And then there are two hip hop cats.
What is that supposed to mean? Hey, bro, be careful what you say next. Hey, bro,
chill out, dog.
There were two
urban cats. Oi, fam, what's popping, bro? We're just a bunch of cats, fam. We're a bunch of cats and that.
So what did the two hip-hop cats... First of all, yeah, no, I would defeat an army of 2 feet cat easily.
Over just Judy Dench. Think about this. Jason Derulo and Rebel Wilson are both in that.
Dude, that's
no
too,
bulge. No bulge edited out.
That's too much brain power to... How can I kill this cat, this horse-sized human cat who can see me from anywhere? And if he grabs me, like, I could stay close, right?
Yeah.
And, like... Be like, you're
That's
so
what you
big.
Have to fight. 2.5 feet of that.
Two and a half feet of Jason.
2.5 feet of talk dirty to me.
God. Yeah, I could take him.
You could take Jason Derulo?
Dude, actually, you're making me reconsider because, like, I feel like, one, totally they could stack up, right? The thing is that I want to be the Judy Dench in this scenario.
You want to be
Judy
Dench.
I
want to
be the thing
Dench.
That they have to defeat.
What if you think you're like, what if you're just like, you're just about to defeat all of them and then they all just combine into Judy Dench cat?
Think about this though. I feel like if anything, I can at least get like one. I can hurt them.
I can kill their morale.
Yeah, if I die.
It's a Megazord
like,
cat.
I know I took out like a good amount of people, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like they'll be like, yeah, Juan lost, but he took out like 5 of them.
I just can't fight a horse-sized anything, you know?
Anything?
Like, I feel like I could maybe...
A horse-sized me you couldn't take down?
I feel like this the size actually
the
does,
size alone.
Like, comes into play, because like you can hurt me if you end up hitting... I can be quick as I can, but no, I feel like, you know...
Yeah.
Anyways,
hip-hop cats.
Hip-hop cats.
So like the people that were actually like cast as these two dudes they're just like super famous hip hop dancers.
Duh.
And so there was a point in the dance where like the entire time they're like the other cats are like doing like ballet type stuff and just like contemporary dance, and then they just come in and just like start doing their hip hop thing, and it just
urban thing.
Yeah, it's just super jarring, and it just like
just
is
out
like,
of place.
It's just very out of place. It's good, but like just out of place. But the part that bothers me the most is that those two cats only are wearing tennis shoes. These cats straight up have Yeezys on.
Wow.
Do you think you could pull them up? Pull up the hip-hop cats. They're straight up in tennis shoes. And you can hear the sneakers like...
Guys, unfortunately...
The Cats movie has bombed. Guys, unfortunately, hip-hop cats exist.
I want to see. First of all, I want to see what the cat would even that. There they are. There's the cat.
There's the hip hop cats.
But I kind of want to see how much. What's their box office? Have they? Do you know if they made box office yet or budget yet?
Honestly, the second time I went and saw it, the theater was pretty full.
Pretty full.
Yeah, it was pretty full. But but I don't think that there's no way they've made it back. There's no way they've made their money back.
Right. I feel like it hasn't.
Like we said it. We said it in what the last. Episode 31.
It wasn't even close. Like,
not
it wasn't even
close.
Halfway.
No.
It wasn't even a quarter of
they
the
made
way.
Like, what was it? They made like $6 million in their opening weekend? Ugh. Or was it like, or was that like their overall gross?
I think it was even less, dude. It was something like really stupid.
I know they didn't even make $1 million back on their previews on their Thursday night showings.
I think people are just relying too much now on namesake.
Yeah.
Like, oh yeah, like even if it's bad, like it will sell because, you know, it's cats.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that's just the thing with just, we talked about this a while ago, but just with live action in general.
Yeah.
Know, like how we were seeing Sonic and all that stuff coming out.
Yeah.
And Lion King and
all
that.
The Sonic
yeah.
movie actually looks kind of.
It looks better now.
It looks
the same exact
better.
Trailer. It just looks better because yeah. Sonic doesn't look like ass.
Yeah.
I watch it. I don't care.
Do you know an odd grievance that I never thought I would have with a movie?
Yeah.
There wasn't enough Jason Derulo.
I feel like they showed him so much for there not to be like.
They
that
showed
much.
Him so much, and he
you always do that.
He's only on for his song. He has his song, and then he leaves, and then he comes back for maybe like 10 minutes.
It's like when Dunkirk always kept showing Harry Styles for no reason.
And then they were just like, guys, we got Harry Styles in Dunkirk. But then he's not even in it. Just like how Midway did the same thing with Nick Jonas. They were like, we got Nick Jonas in Midway. And
I can tell that they're doing that again.
Yeah.
And I was like, y'all.
Or any movie that Finn Wolfhard's in. Like, we got Finn Wolfhard. I hate to say it, I'm actually kind of starting to get sick of Finn Wolfhard a little bit.
You get what?
I'm starting to get sick of Finn Wolfhard a little bit.
Thankfully, he hasn't been anything for me recently, so I have like a little leeway. But I really was when Stranger Things was coming out. It came back the
I've
little hype,
so
and I was just
much.
Like, Jesus Christ!
I've seen him in so much lately.
Really?
He's a good actor, but I'm just like, I'm like, all right, I'm done.
Yeah.
Sam Mendes won best. What's it called? Best director. Best director last night at the Golden Globes, and 1917 won best film. I already said that.
Hell yeah.
But Diego just pulled it up, so I was like, there it is.
That's a good way to end the episode.
Is just letting everybody know that Sam Mendes.
Hey, guys. Sam Mendes won
guys,
best director. I know we are all waiting.
Unfortunately, Sam Mendes has won best director and best film.
All right, guys. I'm Juan.
I'm Nate.
My bad. I forgot that I have to finish it after I started. And this is
Sam Mendes.
This is Sam Mendes winning best director
and best film. Bye, everybody. I'm gonna kill myself.